Governor, your name has been mentioned in by conspirators of the 1837 revolt. Were you an instigator in this revolution to overthrow Governor Albino Perez?
No, no, senor. The people did not like Senor Perez. He was an outsider. He had no Mexican blood in his veins. He was a military leader, not a governor. He did not like the people of New Mexico. He thought he was better even than the ricos. It was the people in the villages of Santa Fe and Santa Cruz and the pueblos that were very angry with Perez, and they did not want him to be governor. They were angry because he instituted taxes for goods and for doing business. The rebels hunted Perez down and beheaded him. They also killed some of his staff members. The conspirators then picked Jose Gonzalez for governor. I ask, if I had been involved in this situation, would I have become the governor? No, no, senora. It was the people who conspired.
It is said you rode to Santa Fe on the eve of the rebellion, thinking that you were to be made governor. But when they installed Jose Gonzalez instead, you headed back to Albuquerque to plot a counter-revolution.
You are too funny, senora. Very funny. You will find no one willing to substantiate that accusation. I was with my familia the entire time of the rebellion and the executions while they were going on. Just ask my nephew. He can tell you.
Governor, according to Josiah Gregg, an American businessman contributed more than 400 pesos for the war chest to remove Jose Gonzalez from office and secure you the office of governor. He trusted you to bring peace and prosperity back to Santa Fe. Why, then, did you alienate the traitors?
Those traitors are just like the stinking tyrants. They had their hand in the rebellion from the beginning. They want New Mexico for the Angelos. Because of the beauty and the selection of their wares, they have made many friends among the Pueblo people and those in Rio Riba. They are blatantly subverting my people here in New Mexico. They only want to make money off of New Mexicans. I am first and foremost a loyal citizen de Mexico. I staunchly uphold its constitution and laws.
Manuel Chavez, your nephew, has stated that you are guilty of insider trading with the Anglos. Did you, Governor, have a great deal of influence on this rebellion by means of trading information to them?
No, no, I would never. Manuel, he is always jumping to conclusions. He is young, you know. The people do not like Senator Perez, and I do not like those filthy Angelos. Yes, I trade with them. We all have to make money. Money buys food and things. But I did not help them with their rebellion to overthrow Governor Perez. I swear I did not give information to those traitors.
Well, after meeting with you here in the governor's palace today, noticing your beautiful furnishings and partaking of your bounteous and most excellent feast, I can't help wondering why you didn't give up your military command and just enjoy the comforts of your governorship. After all, isn't Justiani the only one who really commands?
To be able to step down from that so tedious assignment. The Federales, they will not allow it. I have pleaded. that there are those much more capable to command, but alas, they will not allow it. I am in charge, but I have to admit, I feel like Justini is more a much more capable leader. My men, they think I am a coward because I do not like being in charge when others are more capable.
Can you tell us in your own words what happened to Jose Gonzalez?
See, the people do not know how to pick a leader. They chose this buffalo hunter, part Indian, to be their governor. He could not read. He could not write. A governor must know how to read and how to write. And he did not know how to lead the people. His own people, the ones who picked him, began to conspire against him. We were afraid of anarchy, afraid that these new rebels would destroy Santa Fe. My cousin, Mariano Chavez, helped in planning to overthrow Gonzalez. Mariano called for action against the Santa Fe rebels and the governor, Jose Gonzalez. He declared to the people of Dome, "I know of no one better qualified to lead our army than General Manuel Armijo. Therefore, I ask this assemblage to declare him to be our leader." That's what he said. Thus, I was made leader by the people. I marched my men to Santa Fe, removed Gonzalez and his supporters, and began to set things in order. Then I heard rumors that another attack by the rebels was being planned. I marched out to see Pueblo Montoya, the leader of the canton. We met peacefully, and he agreed to disband the canton. He also turned over four of the leaders of the first rebellion. They will be judged, sentenced, and executed according to the law. When the revolt ended, I ordered the execution of Jose Gonzalez. He gave his confession to Padre Martinez, and the execution order was carried out. The rebellion was ended on September 21st, 1837.
In your opinion, what were the exact reasons for the rebellion?
Well, as I said earlier, Los Angeles stood up the Pueblo Indians and the poor people in Rio Arriba. They chose the young hotheads to mobilize the people into a mob. The poor are the ones who are most affected by the dictators of government. They did not have money or goods to pay taxes that they were being asked to pay. The drought had most of the people starving. Perez, Governor Perez, he was a dog. He wasted the people's money and their resources. The poor are easy to subvert. By reminding them of Perez's extravagance, they could be made angry into revolt. And the Anglos just sit back and watch events happen, hoping that the rebels won't destroy Santa Fe along with taking out Perez.
Well, thank you for your questions. That will be all. The governor has left the building. Thank you.